I think it will be good to merge the session so that the conference can end a little early and everyone can enjoy the weekend. So let's welcome Mr. Ashish, Mr. Rahul, and Mr. B. S. Arun Kumar with a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. And we'll begin, we'll now continue with the presentation from Havells. Thank you.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. You know, we've been hearing a lot about it. Since we're running short of time, I'll straight move on to the subject. We've been hearing about the quality of the power delivered and the quality of the components that are being used in a power plant. So I would be today focusing on something, a very new advancement in basically the string inverter technology, the module level power electronics. I'm Pradeep Menon, I'm representing Havells. Havells got into the solar space about 2 years ago. We are an end-to-end solar company. They're in almost all spectrums of the solar, right from portables to off-grids, hybrid solutions, and the grid tie, and also the street lights and mini-mast sections. Today, but I would be focusing, like I said, on the module level power electronics, which is one of the, which overcomes some of the major challenges, especially in the distributed power segment. You know, everyone has been stressing on, the major challenges that are faced and module mismatch due to various reasons which have been actually elaborated. It can be due to manufacturing tolerances, it can be due to transportation, partial shading due to soiling and other conditions. You know, this has always been a major challenge in any kind of, a grid tie system. As you're all aware, the panels are connected in series, and any kind of a panel mismatch due to shading or any other reason, it reduces the entire string power delivered to the inverter from that particular string. It has been a challenge, and the industry has been, over the past two decades, working on various technologies to overcome that. Havells has recently, partnered a company called SolarEdge, which is an Israeli company and one of the top players in the optimizer-based technology. What basically this technology does is, take the maximum power point tracking to the module level from the inverter level. What normally happens is, when there is any kind of a mismatch or any kind of a shading, the power from one of the panels can go down. Let's say it's a 325 watt panel, maybe because of a 30% shading or any other reason. That particular panel starts working maybe at 225 watts or something. All the panels connected, normally in a traditional string inverter system, maybe 20 or 22 panels that are there, they all start operating at the 225 watt level, thus reducing the overall power delivered and reducing the efficiency of the system. What SolarEdge did was actually, bring the MPPT to each module, thus, making the adjoining panel independent of the other. The affected panel definitely would still continue to operate at 225 watts, but all the other panels in the string, because of the module technology, this optimizer technology, are able to operate at its peak, thus enhancing the power delivered from each individual string to the inverter. Now, when you talk of a ground-mounted system, maybe these are not some of the challenges faced because they are very properly designed. Panels are at the right inclination, matching the latitude, they are south-facing. But when you do the rooftop distributed power systems, normally we face a lot of constraints. The buildings have not been traditionally designed, in anticipation that one day they would be having solar panels on the roof, especially when you're doing industries. They're not in the right orientation. You get buildings which are facing, half the roof in southwest and half maybe northeast. And mostly, especially if you look at the tin roofs, you hardly find any of the roofs which are having an inclination more than 5 or 8 degrees. So especially if you're doing a project in the north, where ideally you would like to keep the panel at maybe 26 degrees or something to extract the maximum, one doesn't. The performance of some of these rooftop systems, when you study, have been found to be, below par. Not sometimes actually, meeting the expectations. When we evaluated a lot of technologies before, when we were looking for a sound partner in the grid tie space, we found the SolarEdge optimizer-based technology to be something different. Today, we have around nearly 240 installations in the last 2 years installed in India, and we have been mapping the performances of these sites. And we have seen almost 4% to 22% extra energy yield. We have sites where, you know, sometimes entirely the panels are facing east and west, but still we have been able to get an average generation of maybe 4.4 to 4.5, you know, units per kilowatt. So this particular technology basically, you know, consists, an optimizer is nothing but a basically a DC-DC device, which is a kind of a buck boost circuit. As the, you know, in, because of some shading or module mismatch or any other reason, if the one of the panels starts performing below par, you know, then normally the internal resistance of the panel is going up. Thus the overall voltage comes down and the whole string voltage comes down. In this case, you see what the, if you see what has been done, the inverter does not have the MPPT part. It's basically split into two parts. Inverter is just a simple DC to AC inverter, high efficiency, and it is runs on a constant, you know, 750 volt DC bus. It is through power line communication, the inverter is constantly talking to each of the individual modules. So as and when an affected panel tries to drag down, the inverter communicates to the balance of the panels in the string and the voltage of those, and it boosts the voltage of the other panels to give a constant 750 volt DC bus. Now this is a major breakthrough. And especially, like I said, you know, diversified, you know, application like roofs and other things where there are, you know, maybe ventilating fans, chimneys, and at different points of the day, different obstructions you see, you know, which are causing a loss of power. This has really helped. And over and above that, the main advantage is like, you know, we have been talking about monitoring systems and all that, but today almost all the monitoring systems provide up to string level monitoring. But here you have got individual module level data available right on your phone. Most of the data on your handphone app itself, you get almost all the parameters that the system can give you. And if you go into the portal and see the thing, you have the IV curve of each individual panel. People talk about, you know, panels, you know, a warranty of 25 years linear performance, but it's a very challenging thing, and I don't know how many developers have actually gone back to a manufacturer and claimed those warranties. It's early days, but it's a tough challenge proving that, you know, this particular individual channel is performing now, and it's a costly affair. In this case, you can generate your the IV curve, you can take a block of panels, show them the comparison, and you can just, you know, pass on the data. So this is something which is very unique to this system. And today, with a lot of RESCO players have also kind of, you know, who are basically, you know, wanting to build their business model on the total yield. They are very, you know, it is very important for them that what is the total power that they generate for having their business model to be a success. This particular technology, though slightly more expensive, and if I may give you a ballpark figure, like at a project level, we are talking maybe, you know, 4 to 6% at the capex stage, but over the lifetime, the savings are, you know, highly exemplified. This apart, I'll quickly run through some of the other benefits of using the optimizer. Like I said, you can put panels all across the roof. You can put it in different orientations. People avoid putting it in different orientations because maybe some other panel, you know, in a different orientation might generate less and pull the whole string down. You can have uneven strings, which are not possible in the traditional string inverter. So you can have a panel string with 26 panels in one string, and I can have the other one at 30 modules. Thus, I can utilize the roof completely. So we have got basically more power on the roof. You can have different kind of modules also in the same string, which are not traditionally done for the same reason, that in a series connection, you know, the lowest, the string would come down to the, you know, lowest panel. We're talking of longer warranties, and somebody just recently mentioned that, would I get the same panel from the manufacturer as a warranty after 8 years? Would a 325 watt panel be getting manufactured at that point in time? Or would the manufacturer say, I'll give you, you know, manufacturer, but I'm giving you a 500 watt panel or a 450 watt panel? What do you do? You can't, if you go and put it back, you're not going to get any great advantage because your earlier panels in the string are 325. Maybe the size is a misfit. You see, there's an optimizer for every kind of panel Like today, even up to 96 cells, an optimizer is available. As the panel technology would evolve, there would always be a particular optimizer. So at least you don't have to change the entire, you know, set of panels or something. You can always put a panel with a different rating in between your regular string. So this is going to, this is a very big advantage. You know, you can say some kind of a small water future proofing your system. There's a huge saving because in this particular system, you know, we load up to 36 panels in a string in the current 325 watt configuration. So a lot of saving in the DC cabling, almost up to 45% to 50%. So that's why I said at a project level, when you look at it, the overall cost, you know, impact for a buyer is between 4% to 6% today. So it is dramatically, you know, pretty competitive, and for all the kind of advantages that are there. One of the most outstanding features which has helped this company become the number one string inverter company in the US and with now almost close to a 60% market share is the DC safe feature. We all know that, you know, the all the inverters have got the anti-islanding, and if the AC power is shut down, the inverters go into a shutdown mode immediately as a safety. But the DC string is still active. You still have the 600 to 800 volt DC bus running through your cables. In case of hazards and fires, it has been noticed that this has been a very major safety problem when they are, you know, they axe the walls or something. Very severe accidents have happened. This is the only solution where the moment the AC switches off, all the optimizers go down to just 1 volt. So when I'm saying even if I'm having 36 panels in a string, I have only 18 volts maximum coming in the string. Is the DC safe? This has now become actually a regulation in almost 35 states in the US out of the 50 states and rapidly gone. Europe is migrating to the DC safe as a regulation. And this has, you know, this is one of the most important features of this particular technology. Like I said, all the modules and everything is there on your app or on your tab. You can just see it. You can just, you know, touch a particular panel. You can know its performance, efficiency. Seeing it on your app, you know if there has been some drastic, sudden, fall in the generation, compared to the previous week, and all kinds of comparative data is also available. It tells you about each individual thing. An alert comes on your mail that there is something wrong. You can specifically, like you got 2 megawatts on a roof, like we have on our factory in Alwar, nearly 2.5 megawatts. There's a huge number of panels to go and identify. Here you know that panel number 3414 is the faulty one. You straight walk up, send your technician right there. So very quick up times, very low O&M cost. Something which has attracted the European and American market, where the O&M is a very expensive proposition. So I think something which is now also being there. Some of our channel partners have actually, because using this tool, made O&M a revenue business now. They were only earlier only into the INC and installation part. But now because of this kind of communication tool available, they have now signing longer term contracts of O&M with their customers. So you get both the physical layout as well as the logical layout in this. If the panels were oriented in a different thing, they automatically, the moment you connect all the modules to the inverter, the automatically it places and gives you the correct orientation. So you're very easy to identify. Inverter data and all other data, like in any other remote monitoring system, is also available. And this is the kind of, the energy, various kind of screens that are available to have a quick analysis of all these. So something, so this is how a photograph of the optimizer, which comes, normally in the residential category, which we say up to 15 kilowatt, there is one optimizer per module. And in the industrial and commercial space, there is one optimizer for 2 modules. So they're connected and, very easy. It's just a kind of a plug and play, and just you can mount it either on the firm or on the mounting rails or under the module frame. And last, I'd like to tell you, these are the only inverters which have a starting warranty of 12 years and can be extended up to 25 years at a very nominal cost. And the optimizers come with a standard 25-year warranty. So I think it's a pretty value-added package. Like today, a lot of our customers insist other manufacturers also to give a 25-year warranty on the project, on the inverters as well. Well, when they work with some of the other competing inverters, the cost has to, maybe one or two inverters has to be loaded. And you know, and when you look at it from that point of view, this is a much, much more competitive solution. So we have a very wide range now. The range has been enhanced from now 33 kilowatt right up to singles 100 kilowatt string inverters with medium voltage and up to 82 kilowatt string inverters, you know, which can do. And in 1 megawatt, actually now they all come with an internal Wi-Fi. So it hardly takes about 15 minutes to commission a 3 megawatt system. Once you have plugged the inverters, 31 of them talk to each other, one becomes a master, and it only, there's no screens, we have removed all the screens and other things from the inverter. You can only use the app, and it takes roughly about 15 minutes to 20 minutes to commission a 3.2 megawatt system after it's plug and play. And the 100 kilowatt inverter is something that two people can carry and install. So it's a very, very flexible system, and you know, now the full range is there. Also, we are now launching the 1 to 2.5 for the homes, you know, which was earlier a slightly price challenged product, but specifically for India, now SolarEdge has developed this product where one optimizer for 8 panels. So that has kind of rationalized the cost, and plus also, you know, even for small residential applications now, this technology can be extended. Pretty large installations have already been done, nearly, like I said, 240 installations in India so far. Very recently, one of the major corporations has gone for a 25 megawatt ground project, ground mounted project also with these inverters and optimizer technology. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm.